Preparatory High School of MSU to please come forward. And the Science High School of MSU Tawi-Tawi PCTO. Again, this is an annual debate and public speaking competition. We hope that the principals, supervisors, college professors, and school directors will continue this culture of debate and public speaking in their schools, provide opportunities for young children, young students, to hone their critical thinking, persuasive speaking. So this round one for the high schools, for today, but this is actually the second round, debating on the motion that this house will return the death penalty. We have from the government, the Prime Minister, Angelien B. Permil. Angelica B. Permil. The Deputy Prime Minister, Sharaleen L. Ali. The Government Whip, J.R. L. Mohammad Saeed. And the reply is Sharaleen L. Ali. They are from the MSU Preparatory High School, while we have from the MSU TCPO Science High. For the Leader of Opposition, we have Aisha P. Hussein. The Deputy Leader of Opposition, we have Fatima Shaira A. Bayrola. And the Opposition Whip, we have Monica T. Niello. As well as the reply will be Fatima Shaira A. Bayrola. So, to debate on the motion that this House will return the death penalty in the Philippines, the Prime Minister can begin.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning to each and everyone. I'll speak first to relation. This House will return the death penalty in the Philippines. Death penalty is a capital punishment in which the accused is put to death as a punishment for a crime he committed. The capital punishment is awarded for those crimes that are considered capital crimes, as such as terrorism, murder, and other severe crimes. The advantages of the death penalty are as follows. First, it shows that justice doesn't show sympathy for criminals. Evil crimes committed by the criminals against innocent people should be put to death penalty as a matter of justice. Not for the sake of death, not for the sake of killing, but for the sake of eliminating frustrating elements in the government in our country. The second goal is to lessen the crime and criminals. Third, at this present days, the rates of crimes are increasing by kidnapping, murder, kidnapping, riding in tandem, and many more. This gruesome has been done by the criminal without hesitation. Why? Because they know that the capital punishment of the Philippines was like. Criminal knows that if they committed a crime, they will be sent off to jail, not having any punishment like death penalty. Okay, fourth, it provides a safe and productive environment. We believe that by implementing death penalty in the Philippines would lessen and control the crimes just like other countries. We think that it is time to restore the death penalty as a capital punishment of the Philippines to discipline and to change the point of view of all citizens. of the Philippines, including the other countries. That will be all.
Reminder, you're not allowed supposed to read too much from your notes, but also master your point.
We are from the opposing team from Sansai School. We are to argue that the death penalty regime should not be promulgated or implemented because only him could take one's life. It is said in the Quran that we are created with the best mode. So we are only creations. Does the creation has the right to get one's life of another creation? Here, the first reader said that justice doesn't show sympathy. But doesn't she or they think that God also shows sympathy to man? So why we people can't do so or has no right to forgive something that committed crime? She also said that it could lessen crimes, but in my opinion, crime could be lessened when the government are not corrupted or corruption would be eliminated. Lessening the crime is not only by returning the death penalty, but also by improving the economy of our country. Justice can be get by if the rulers of our country would be not corrupt, will be honest and loyal to us. We can also find justice or lessen the crimes if justice is promulgated or the rights of the humans are also included in taking one's rule. If the death penalty has been implemented previous years, so and removed, and why do we need to implement it? This is removed because there's something wrong. So why we should return it? Thank you. That will be all.
Good morning, everyone. Okay, so the leader of our division had mentioned earlier that only him can take the life of a human. Okay, so if I may just state that even in the religious countries like Saudi Arabia, they are in favor of death penalty because this is not about vengeance, this is about justice. Okay, and we all know that Philippines is not united with the church. The government of the Philippines is not united with the church. This is not the authority wherein there is the independent church and the government. Okay, so the crime with the death penalty is the best way to decrease the increasing rate of crimes. The citizens of the Philippines will be afraid of committing crime if the death penalty is implemented, and also the drug smugglers in other countries. My idea in this feature is to use lethal injection. Lethal injection as a punishment of death penalty. This punishment was not barbaric, instead of torturing or applying a barbaric punishment in the criminal. So the government can use lethal injection. Implementing the death penalty is bad, but if the lives of many persons in the state are treatment of criminals, meaning as an act and determining near our conversation, how to solve this problem. Death penalty must implement and use correctly so that it cannot violate the human rights of the people. We have the right to live. Life is the name of God, right? So we need to respect it and care with it. That will be all. Thank you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh and good morning to everyone. The side of the government will be continually saying justice. But I believe, as what Martin Luther King Jr. said, peace doesn't only exist without the absence of war, but also in the presence of justice. When we are going to implement the so-called death penalty, what about the justice of those who are accused? What about the justice? We have given people rights by God and as well as our constitution. We have given people rights as human beings. So therefore, we also implement the people rights. We need to look at human equality. Not because that we are the criminal, we should punish them to death. No. Because we will always have the chance for them to change. That's why we have this long sentence of imprisonment. Where you can still give them a chance to change and to live. And to know that there is still something in this life. And then our government is making different programs to action crimes. And I believe they are doing well from that. If we are going to implement this death penalty, sometimes this will also be abused. Others will use this as their personal intention. They will put more people down because they have this intention. And we don't know if this person is really guilty or not guilty. Because really, justice will only appear if those people in position are they themselves capable to know. If they themselves are not guilty, if they themselves are a very good, if they themselves are a very good judge. So it all depends on the people, the government. But I do believe that we should not put this death penalty into our constitution again. That's all. Thank you.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. If we only subject our criminals with the years of imprisonment, after their freedom, there is a tendency that they will do the crime again. Eventually, a new crime will be committed. To sum it all, what my team is trying to say is that death penalty is the solution for a healthy and productive environment. How? Of course, if there are lesser criminals, the environment is safer and more peaceful. Death penalty must implement and use correctly so that it cannot violate the human right of the people. We have the right to live. Life is a gift of God. We need to respect it and take care of it. That would be all. Thank you.
Assalamualaikum. So the government side just said that we have the right to live. Life is a gift of God. So when we implement this so-called death penalty, Where is the justice? I mean, crime. Aren't you a crime if you are going to kill one's life? Yes, we will minimize, no, not minimize. We will punish them for this crime. But aren't you yourself a crime if you kill them? And are we sure that this death penalty is going to minimize the criminals? Are we sure? So they also said that we have equal rights. What if the government, no, what if the one, what if the innocent was being charged of something not true? What if they were said that they were guilty, but they're not? So it is not right if we are going to impose this death penalty. They also said that justice doesn't show sympathy for criminals. This shows that we people are violating the rules of God. We are given life, so we have to protect it. So this death penalty is not, I believe that this death penalty should not be imposed in this country. Assalamualaikum once again. Ladies and gentlemen, the opposition side doesn't believe to the points raised by the government. Because in the Philippines, we are living in a religious country. Even though we are diverse, even though we have different religions here, people believe really in the existence of our Almighty God. So therefore, we believe that He is the only one who can take lives of human beings. We can have laws that can equal the crime that we have committed. So why not that penalty? So that would be all. Thank you. Good morning once again. Okay, so the opposition team has mentioned again about God gave a present to us in lieu of us cheating, gives importance to our life. But again, I want to mention that religion is different, that the church is not even united with a government. The church is different from the government. This is not their government. This is not their government. Okay? And another thing, we think that all the different ideas about economic development. Okay, so how can we develop the economy of the Philippines if there are many criminals? Okay? If you don't have any criminals in the Philippines, there will be a healthy environment and a safe environment. How? Just what your team has said is by death penalty, those. Okay? And then the death penalty can also address the problem of overpopulation in the Philippines. We all know that. If the education centers and prison camps are overpopulated, we're obsolete
people to other criminals. Come on, guys. What else? So when we have a death penalty, if we only subject them with years of imprisonment, they're going to sentence them, and they're going to be able to do again the crime that they did before. So my team is strongly fighting for implementation of death penalty. That was it all. Thank you.